Here's a face who really needs no introduction, although we're going to give you one. Internationally renowned comedian turned actor turned author, Rhys Darby has released the grand finale in his series of kids' books, The Top Secret Intergalactic Notes of Button McGinty, Book 3. Yes. Book 3, he arrived back on home soil earlier this year after being based in the bright lights of LA, and he joins us in the studio. So nice to have you here, Rhys.
Thank you for having me.
Rhys Darby did the words and the pictures.
That's right.
Yeah, and then you've been sitting down on the couch for about 30 seconds and you said, I did the words and the pictures, I did the pictures.
I'm really pushing that.
you're proud of it, aren't you?
Yes, well, yeah. I've always been a bit of a drawer, and art was definitely my number one subject at school. The rest, you know, fell by the wayside a bit, but I was good at drawing. And I used to draw little cartoons when we were sort of in science class or geography, and my mates would sort of demand the latest update on the comic, so I'd be doing that while everyone else was... Yeah, so I was a bit naughty. In fact, don't do that if you're a kid. But, you know, it worked out for me.
Well, don't do that if you're a kid because... Well, maybe do that if you're a kid. I mean, maybe...
A little bit of it, yeah. But also pay attention in class, which I never did, and so I never know what's going on.
My favourite page is page 91, which includes dad jokes. Why didn't the train eat its dinner?
Because it couldn't chew.
Gold!
You got me on the spot there.
Of course, gold.
I wrote these a long time ago.
Yeah, that's a gold dad joke.
Thank you.
The really nice thing about this is if you are just coming into Button McGinty in book 3, you do a stuff you should read should read before you start the story. So you don't have to have read 1 and 2. Ideally, you would like that because that's how you earn your living and art. But you can pick it up from 3. You can start from 3.
Yeah, there's a recap in each book. So if you just want to get that one, you can. But there are, of course, the other two. There's the cameras. They keep moving. There they are. So, each one of them was 6 months of my life, handwritten.
Did you do the drawings yourself?
hang on. I did the drawings myself. Yeah, I did. So it's written on there.
The reason I'm being silly is they're joyful books, aren't they? And I can tell, you know, sometimes you think, oh, a famous person's written a book. Oh, my God. But there's such...
Famous person. Oh God. Leave, please. Why are you famous? Why are you talented, are you? Can't stand it. Well, here's the thing. When I was a kid, I was a reluctant reader. So I looked at a book full of words and I thought, how am I going to get those words into my head? And even if I did, where's the joy going to come? I'd rather go skateboarding. So, and there's a lot of, especially boys, difficult to read, you know, and so I was one of these kids. So what interested me was like drawings, jokes, maps, diagrams. So I'm more of a sort of a tactile reader. So when I wrote this, this is the sort of thing I would love to read as a kid because there's Morse code in there that you've got to work out.
Yeah, there's one section I remember when you've got to disconnect the cables and you're asking people which ones you should disconnect. Obviously, they're not able to answer because they're reading a book. But what you're doing, what you're doing is drawing people in, right?
Exactly. Interacting with the reader.
Why do the parents always have to disappear? Why is every children's story begin with the parents disappear? I mean, is it...
Because I think it means the kid has to stand up on his own or her own and venture forth using courage and confidence.
Yeah,
and that's something that kids love to do. And my 10-year-old today has got a big task. He's leaving school at 3 and he's got to walk up to the pub and meet mum and dad on his own because we're watching the election live at the...
At the pub.
At one of the pubs, local pubs.
Yeah. Right.
But so this is a big challenge for him. Of course, we've got this stalker app where we can monitor where he's moving. So I'll be able to see him going up the street on my phone. And I'll be able to, oh, he's gone the wrong way, and I'll be running down to him. Theo, no, don't cross the road there! You know, and that kind of thing. But, you know, this is his big adventure. And so. And also this book, for me, it's about kids starting to do journals and sort of write.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
It's also about a love of words and a love of adventures and a sense of possibility, right?
Yeah.
Button's McGinty. Right, Button's McGinty's book 1, 2 and 3. When's 3 out? Is it out today?
It's out now.
Yeah.
Yeah. All through New Zealand and Australia. And online on the online stores.
Yeah. Camera 4.
I'm not pushing them that much. Just, you know, Christmas is coming up. I love you guys. How many more minutes have we got?
No, that's it, you're done. Okay. Rhys Darby, thanks so much for coming. So nice to see you, Rhys.
You
always
too.
Is.